Godrej Properties posted its second quarter numbers. Profits were up 5%. Revenues also saw a boost of about 39%. Pirot Shah Godrej, MD CEO at Godrej Properties, now joins us on this conversation. Pirot Shah, many thanks for joining us on Bloomberg. My first question to you, I want to understand how you see demand playing out in the residential and commercial real estate segments. Are you expecting volume growth in 2014?
Great to be with you, Harsha. I think, you know, as we look at the current environment, both on the residential and commercial front, I think for the sector as a whole, sales have been quite sluggish. I think clearly the weak economy, and particularly in Q2, the rupee fluctuations and other concerns have led to a dampening of demand for real estate. But certainly we expect a much better year in 2014, and I think there will be several drivers of that better performance. I think while interest rates in the short run have increased, I think the tightening cycle will be complete in the current calendar year, and hopefully towards the middle or end of next year we can see rates starting to come down again. Also next year, of course, we have the big event of the election, and I think once the uncertainty of that event is over and once a new government with a fresh mandate comes in, we are quite hopeful that they will be able to push through a more robust economic reform agenda. And I think all of these can have a very big impact on consumer sentiment. And ultimately, real estate is a very sentiment-driven sector.
Sure.
If a customer believes things are headed in the right direction, he doesn't necessarily need to wait for GDP growth to pick up. I think it is that confidence that it will pick up
right. That
can lead to much better sales for the real estate sector. And I think, you know, we've seen recent evidence of that even in 2008-09, where after a very, very challenging period, the turnaround was very quick and very robust. So our hope and expectation is certainly that next year will be a much stronger year for the sector.
Pirot Shah, I understand that you have a $1.5 billion investment plan in the next 10 years. If you look at it in the short term, what are the projects in the pipeline? Where will you be spending all of this?
Sure, I think it's important to understand that investment in a real estate business, or certainly for a business with a model like ours, which is joint ventures, doesn't actually mean balance sheet investment. These investments will largely be made through funds we raise through sales in the project. So it's really an accrual-based investment that will be considered. And actually, over a 10-year period, I think it'll be much larger than the number you mentioned. Of course, an exact figure is very difficult to arrive at. It'll depend on a large number of factors, including how successful we are in maintaining our recent track record of adding very value-creative new projects, how successful we are in rapidly scaling up our execution. But certainly, I think the aspiration of the company is to grow our business very quickly. We think we have every opportunity, given our national presence, given the benefits our brand gives us, given our joint venture business model. We think that, you know, there is a large amount of opportunity. And, of course, sentiments, I think, currently in the sector and amongst investors in the sector are, of course, a little bit dampened given the challenging economic environment that the sector has faced. But this is very much, to our mind, a short-term phenomenon. And I think our way of looking at it is, of course, that we need to do our best to drive current sales and maintain strong operating performance, even in a tough environment, but also take advantage of the dislocation in the market that is created by these weak economic times and use our ability to generate capital to invest intelligently and conservatively in attractive new projects.